Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Just gonna do a test of my sound because it was a bit of a pain in the ass last time. Seems like I can hear. All right, we're good to go. All right, so a couple of things I wanted to talk about just before we get into things. I'm just gonna load up DCS today, and we're gonna rock another Warthog mission. I've set up another strike mission, but we'll get to that in a minute. Oh, deal with my finger. Oh man, I love that. I'll never forget that. That's the most hilarious thing in the world. So getting into things today. Some big doings in my channel. I've gotten into making it look a little bit more professional. Like right now I'm running on Gamecaster, and I'm just working with the default stuff. But I've actually gone and I've made myself I've gotten a very talented group of individuals on Fiverr to help me out putting together a new stream overlays, and you might have seen the new logo that I've gotten. So I'm pretty excited about that, and trying to make it a little bit more professional looking for you guys. So there's that. And also I'm looking at getting upgrades for my setup here. Right now I'm running the Rhino X56s, which are they're good, they're very good. But can't be the hog driver without the A10 Warthog. So we're going to get the Thrustmaster Warthogs set up hopefully soon, and it'll give me a little bit more control over the aircraft. And I've been told that the difference is just absolutely night and day. So we'll definitely look into that. I've made a purchase on the Mi-24 Hind in DCS. I didn't realize that. I think the date might have got bumped or something, but it's June 16th, so we're gonna try and crack that open, and we'll try that out. I'm not big on rotary, so it might be a fun stream. What else? Honestly, I think that's just about it, but it's big doings for me, and I really want to try and like a big goal for me right now. I want to try and reach affiliate. So if you're watching and you don't mind just giving me a follow, I'd really appreciate it. I'm not looking to become the world's biggest streamer of all time. I'm just happy to show my content on Twitch and whatever I'm streaming to. I just want to find like-minded individuals who like watching this kind of stuff, and I really appreciate my audience. But without further ado, I think we're going to get started on the mission. Let's take a quick look. I'm just going to get loaded in, and just bear with me. That is not what I wanted to do. There. So we're gonna load up another custom mission I've done today. Just pretty simple, but we're gonna do the same thing as last time, just I'm not going to leave you stuck in the MFD screens the entire time. We're going to make sure to pay attention to that, so that you can get a piece of all the action. Little hind there. That might come into play later. Who knows? Okay, so I'm going to play around with the volume this time. It wasn't so great last time. You couldn't quite hear me. So we'll see how that. I'm going to say, what, 45%? Try that out. Okay, so I'm going to do a walkthrough again this time, and I do not have track IR on. Uh-oh. Stand by. I will be right back. I am so sorry. Sorry, just getting used to switching which screens are which. Yeah, sorry, just I forgot to turn on track IR, so we're just waiting for DCS to reboot because it doesn't play nice with track IR when you try to boot track IR after starting the game, so you have to restart the game. So just give it a moment. Right there. Okay, so let's get set up here and there we go. Now we can look around. Okay, so we're gonna take off from Liwa Air Base and getting attacks from the Oman border. Intel suggests a team of tanks is on its way. Also, there is an artillery base that we need to try and level, and a convoy of ammunition is heading towards this complex along the road. Intel also suggests that they might have air support. All right, so without further ado, let's do our startup. Right, so if you remember from last time, our startup always starts off with turning on our battery. I'm going to throw my glasses on because I do like to see. And we're going to turn on our inverter. Remember, some of my switches are on the HOTAS, such as the APU. So I'm going to boot up the APU. Now, another audio test for me. This stream is a lot about trying to get things kind of working properly. Alright, can you hear me okay over the APU? I think everything's good. Alright, let's begin. Alright, so we got the APU spooled up. Let's just make sure it's at 100%. Alright, let's start. Our left engine. And we'll go ahead and close our canopy. Just keep an eye on our gauges. But in the meantime, just while things are spooling up here, we've got an armament of two 2,000-pound JDAMs, just like we did last time. Six Maverick missiles on Lau 88s. We've got two Sidewinders for air defense, one lightning pod, and one jamming pod. Alright, so let's get stuff started up. So we're going to boot up our CDU, EGI, CQ, JTRS, and IFFCC, and turn on our displays. And we can go ahead and spool up our right engine. Start to spin. Good. Now with power, we can turn on our SAS and set our takeoff trim. Radios to heat on. Keep an eye again as your engine's going. I'm going to hit load all on my DTS. Upload. Turn on our ejector seat. Flip on anti-skid, uncage or standby attitude indicator. Yes, this is all stuff I'm remembering that I had turned off. Let's set our fuel to main. Fuel's going to be important. This is a long trip. Well, fuel is always important. Let's turn on our helmet mounted display. Check that it's working. Good. Flaps and takeoff position. And let's keep an eye on our CDU. It is currently in alignment, or coming in to be alignment. So tasty, as in the cockpit, so tasty, because the A-10 is the most beautiful plane in the world. Brown Ghost, by the way, welcome to my stream. Thanks for giving it a watch, and thanks for taking the effort to rush home to take a watch. Alright, so we're just going to be waiting on that alignment. Let's check on our MFDs. I'll actually switch so you can see. Okay, so in our MFDs, you can't see so well because I guess I have my box in the way there, but in the we're gonna go into our Dismas. We're just gonna check and make sure that our weapons are all there. So we have two GBU-31s, and that's let's check. Yep, on the belly. And fives and one. And five and one, sorry. And then we have three AGM-65Ds on port and starboard, three and nine. That's correct. And then we have an AIM-9 on our port side. Two of them. Correct. And then our ALQ-184 jamming pod in our 11 spot. And then our lightning pod in the 10. Good. And speaking of lightning pod, let's throw that on while we're still waiting for that little line. And we might as well arm the laser. Alright, let's check the board, make sure we're not missing anything. Yep, we're just waiting on nav and EAC. That's just about everything. Okay, so we're showing aligned, so we're good to go. I almost did it again, but then I checked. Make sure to put you guys back. Okay, good to go. So we're aligned. I'm gonna set EGI on. Oh, it didn't go. Why didn't it go? Nav, EGI on, EAC on. Good. Alright, good for rollout. So, I'm not entirely sure I'm not familiar with this runway. Oh, okay, so I just roll out. Alright. So we're going to runway 13. I'll turn on nose wheel steering so I can actually steer. I've always found that helps. Hey, Brown Ghost, if you're watching right now, or if you remember when we used to play at the old Fusion Center, we used to fly the Frogfoot. I think it was the Frogfoot, wasn't it? It was the Frogfoot that came free. In current DCS world, the Frogfoot actually comes free with the game. So if you can get yourself on a PC, we should do old Frogfoot missions again, just like the old Fusion Center. Sorry, just testing out my track IR again. Sorry, got a little bouncy. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Okay, so quick takeoff checklist. So I'm just gonna spool. We'll go to 60% RPM. Seems good. I'm going to keep my CDU on, but I'm going to switch to my TAD, and I want to depart quickly as possible, so I'm going to set my first waypoint. Alright, so I think we're good to go. We're a little heavy, so probably going to rotate between 125 and 130 knots, but let's roll out. Positive rate, gear up, laps up, check that they're going up. Okay, good to go. Little vanity view for us all. Okay, just keep this steady climb, trim, trim, trim. A little more trim. It's still wavering a little bit, but that's okay. Alright, so we got 47 miles to the first engagement, so we got plenty of time to climb. I'm gonna aim for about 7,500 feet. There. Alright, Alright, I'm going to check on my targeting pod to get all that set up. Let's quickly turn on the heading here. Okay, so I got a general location. Now, sometimes when I'm in the mission editor, I do something stupid and I will forget to set my marker or my waypoint, my turning point to the ground. So you end up with something silly happening where now I'm going to try and put my targeting pod onto the target with China Hat forward, and oh no, what happened? It's in the air. And then you try to search around, and you're like, well, where is it? Where's the target at? And you can't seem to find it because your slew's all messed up. Well, there's a trick to it. So, we're going to get to target altitude, and I'll give you a little bit of a show of what you can do to narrow down that search if you mess up that waypoint instead of sticking with the waypoint in CPU, which is one option you can do. But the other way is actually a little bit sneakier, so we'll keep an eye out here. So you're getting close to target altitude. About 35 clicks out, or yeah, 38 clicks out. I'm gonna level up actually at about 7,000, so it's somewhere out about. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna show you what I mean. Okay, so here we are. And you can kinda see what I'm talking about. Hopefully you can see my mouse kinda sitting around in there. I don't know if you can or not. See, I use the TAD to actually line up exactly where we're going. So if I zoom in a hair on the TAD, so let's make the TAD sensor of interest. We're going to zoom in a hair. Oh, I've done something silly here. Okay, but if you can see, we're hooked in, as you can tell by the hat symbol, on our waypoint 2. Okay? You can also see there's a diamond that moves around. If I were to make the targeting pod soy, there's a diamond that you can see that moves around in the TAD. You can take that diamond and put it right on the soy. Or sorry, on the speed, my bad. And if you zoom in, you'll have a rough location where the target is. Don't zoom in too much. Now, let's just take a quick look here. Okay. So, our target should be around here somewhere. So let's zoom out a little bit. And as we get closer, we should be able to see. Oh, I got eyes. Let's zoom in. Oh, would you look at that? There they are. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 T-55s. Now, I don't want to use all my Mavericks, but I think we can snapshot a whole bunch of these all at once. Now, we're sitting about 25 nautical miles slant range now. So I think what I'm going to do I'm going to... Oh, sorry, I keep looking down on the pits there. Mind you guys. Sorry about that. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is I'm going to set mark points on a couple of the tanks. And, ooh, I have forgotten to warm up my Mavs. Yikes. So we'll warm up the Mavericks here. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to set mark points on a couple of the tanks, so that we can snapshot some Mavericks. So, we have... I'm going to slow down a little bit because we're getting pretty close and Mavericks need some time to spawn. But, yeah, we can really see the tanks now, can't we? Alright, well, hopefully the Mavericks align soon, so we'll wait for that alignment. But I think what I'm going to do... pop these three, and then I'm going to try and gun run these three here, and we'll see how we do. Might take a couple of passes, but it's for fun. And of course you're going to see now, check my quick reference sheet. Just to make sure I know what I'm doing here. Sometimes it can be a bit of a pain remembering all of the different DMS, TMS, China hat, boat switch, pinky switch, cooling hat, what they all do, so I have a quick reference guide I made. Okay. So I think what I'm going to do... I don't remember how long the alignment is. I think it's 4 minutes. So hopefully it'll be good by the time, because I'm just kind of slowing this down a little bit. Keep about 200 knots, maybe higher. Okay. So. Alright, so we're going to create a mark point. Snapshot these. So that's a mark point. I'll make sure these are actually being made. That's a mark point. That's a mark point. Let's make sure these are actually even being made. I don't think they are. Okay, well, this is happening anyway. Go back to the Mavericks. Master arm is currently safe. Let's flip up the master arm gun pack. Good.
Warning, autopilot.
Yeah. Well, we don't need the autopilot right now. also, oh god, I hate these marks. There, that's better. Okay, so we're gonna make the Maverick soy. And we're gonna bring him in. I don't know why it's being like this. Okay. Oh, I know why it's being like this. Uh-oh. So, okay, I'll do it manually. Alright, so I see the tanks. We're gonna get in nice and slow. For some reason, it's not locking. Why is it not locking? Oh, I know why. I have not set my Mavericks. Oh, no, 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 no. Okay, pull off. Looking like an amateur today, guys. Embarrassing for me. Yes, I got you stuck in the MFD. That's my bad. Get you out of there for a second. So, what I've done wrong is I've gotten all caught up talking about this and that and the other thing, and then I forgot to select them in the Dismas so they wouldn't lock. But that's okay. They're just gonna fly away. They're just behind us now. So I'm gonna go to the TAD really quickly. I'm gonna watch my distance. See, I'm a little bit close. So I'm gonna turn around at about 5 miles. Get some altitude as well. Because I might launch my missiles and then go in for a gun attack. Okay, so let's quickly set our TGP. Flavor sensor. I really don't know what is going on here. Something has gone horribly wrong here. No idea where the tanks are. It's becoming a pain. What's the next? Why am I not getting a... something has gone horribly wrong. I appear to have gotten rid of Soy. Alright, I got eyes on tanks. Rifle. 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 Not that one. Next one. That one. Let's see how these land. Seems like we've messed up. That's frustrating. I'm having trouble right now. I've got eyes on them. I'm getting glitches from my Mavericks. Kind of having trouble right now. Now wasted four Mavericks. So you can probably tell I'm not very pleased. That's okay. There is far too much symbology in the way right now. I can barely see what I'm doing. Fire. We've got quite a bit of damage. We're in and still running though. We're good to go. Master caution, what's our problem? Left generator's failing. Doing this. Well, we are beyond in trouble right now. Left engine's probably about to flame out. Got a little overzealous. Well, let's get her home then. I did not mean to put your hat on. I'm having trouble today, I'll tell you. You're stuck. You gotta be kidding me. There. Alright, we're gonna try and get it home. It's not going well. The emergency is gonna force me. Your emergency jettison store.
Altitude.
Okay, lost everything there. Getting a bit more control of the aircraft. A little bit, but I've got to max out my trim here to make it happen. Unfortunately, I don't have my throttle set up to be independent, so I have to kind of fight. Alright, let's get TAD open, CDU open. No. Oh. No. God damn it. Am I not set to mission? God. Okay. This is the most embarrassing flight I've ever done. I want to go to B1 now. Barely seeing in the air. That's not Liwa. My navigation's all messed up. I don't know how to fix it. God damn it. Why has my navigation got me all turned around? It's gonna be a slow one, folks, but I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Shouldn't have got so cocky. trim on this, this is gonna be nightmarish. Sorry folks, I must have the hot brain right now, or maybe I just had my vaccine, maybe it's messing with my brain. Miles to go, guys. These tanks are like snipers. I'm gonna check to see if I jettison the A9s. Okay, I actually don't know anything about that, so I'm just gonna actually stop. Not push my luck here. barely flying, folks. Barely flying. Sorry if I'm a little quiet. It's hard to maintain the trim. We will get there, though. And the landing will be perfect. And I'm gonna get on 310 course as soon as I can. I'm actually gonna get some help from Lila Air Force Base if I can.
In field, 1-1, inbound.
Negative. No, we are not landing on runway 13.
In field, 1-1. Request navigation assistance.
So far, this has just been a litany of mistakes. I'm sorry, guys. I swear to God, it'll be better. Everyone's watching this. Probably think, goddamn, hope this guy crashes. We'll land, we'll get fixed up, we'll get rearmed, and then we're going back out there. Jesus, warm. Hand off the stick for a sec to save the aircraft. Take that gun pack on, that was probably a problem as well, actually. Somewhat on course. On course. Sorry. Lulled in the mic there. Alright, sorry. Hopefully you can hear me. We'll throttle the full. Hydraulic pressure, yeah. It's all reflecting in the aircraft. Yeah. It's dead in the water, basically.
Nice peaceful flight deck. Very quiet. Don't worry, we'll get revenge. I could just restart, but honestly, ladies and gentlemen, what's the point of playing a sim? So, we're going to be doing an emergency landing on 3-1. It wants me to go to 1-3, but that's not happening. I don't think I'd survive that turn. I bleed too much energy. I'm only at 2,400 feet. We'll get her home. Flaps are just full ugly. I'm gonna keep it that way until we get closer to the runway. Then I kind of want this thing to go down like a brick because we're very, 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 very light right now. As you can see, they jettison all the white squares. We're just trying to get home alive, that's all. The navigation's all messed up as well, unfortunately. Base. Helmet mounted display is the nicest thing that's ever been added into this. Aircraft, I have to say. Okay, we're gonna lose a little bit, just a tiny bit of altitude, not too much. Just to keep our speed up. So I'm gonna have to do a turn. Bleed some of that. We're applying it a little bit, so I'm actually bleeding my energy, which shouldn't happen. Try and keep level flight. 3 miles. My nose just a tiny bit, get some speed before this turn, because I don't want to bleed too much energy. I'm busy. Okay, we're gonna start gradually making the turn. Dump my nose a little bit more. We're still above 2,000 ASL. God, the trim. The trim! Oh! God, it's bad. Oh. Okay, gear is down unlocked. Flaps are pretty flighty right now. We're actually gonna put them up a little bit. What? Are we stuck? Yep, the hydraulics are stuck, so now I have to fight my flaps. I didn't realize that. Okay, I don't care about the master caution, please stop. I can. It's beautiful, that's beautiful. Okay. We can control this descent a little bit. What's my speed? 144, 143. Okay, we're losing lift. Considerable amounts of lift.
Altitude.
We don't need to go for the direct threshold. Let's try a little further ahead on the runway. I'm all rudder right now. Just trying to... That's my airspeed warning. It's okay. Taxi to parking area, huh? Okay. Well, we did it. How did we collapse the landing gear? Well, it was an emergency landing to end all emergency landings. I'm apparently not allowed to do any views. That was the flight so far. Let's start again, okay? This is season log action on Twitch. Noodle No Step, welcome, by the way. Too many hornets and vipers. Yeah, I got my engine out. Not the cleanest of landings. hope that wasn't too offensive to watch. Alright, well, we'll go through the startup real quick again this time. Alright. I'm not gonna talk through this startup this time, we'll just get her done. Flynn. Absolutely. Yeah, any one that you can walk away from is a good one. Well, it's crazy because that's how it was designed, right? It's why the gear is just in these pods on the wings is because it actually, you can land it that way. That's how it's supposed to be done when the gear collapses. Oh, I wasn't paying attention to your standby. Alright, we're good to start. And I knew that's the result, Noodle, that I was going to get. The trim was way out of whack. It was almost like I barely had any control surfaces. I could barely maintain over 125 knots, and I had no hydraulics. Somehow I was able to get the speed brakes out, so that was nice to slow my descent, but other than that, I was basically dead stick. So I think I did an alright job, considering. I didn't realize it was going to spin out like that, though. Or that they were going to collapse forward like that. So we'll go on our SAS. Our takeoff trim going now. Started. CQ, JTR, SI, FFCC, displays on. I like to have my fuel display up there. Radio, transmit, receive. Start up my right engine now. Good. Alright. I like that Master Caution doesn't boop at you anymore. Pain in the ass. Way back when it used to have to boop at you every second. Alright, CMSP. Which would have been handy last time. Another display going. And we have a note. Checker displays. Okay, good. Yep, yeah, there wasn't much there, right? Right, so it's so much more fun because you have an actual challenge apart from just getting blown out of the sky at the end of it. But it was funny, like, it was just a litany of stupid mistakes that led to it in the first place. But, yeah, it's a nice, fun thing to do in the sim, because you don't know how it's going to end. I thought, hey, maybe I could get it to land. No. But it was a good, fun try, that's for sure. I don't like what my track IR is doing right now. It's kind of bugging. Yeah, I know. I've yet to find a group that I fit into. I keep landing in. See, I'm not like, I love the sim and everything, and I like that, but I just I haven't found a group of folks yet that I kind of like flying with. I don't want to start out too hardcore, and I got people like my first setup with a couple of groups. They were like, all right, so now we have a mandatory 4-hour meeting about radio brevity. And I'm like, you know, like I just got home from work. I don't want to talk about radio brevity right now. Like I'm not super great at radio brevity, but you know, like I can make it real. but like I come home to relax after work, not that. That's just too much fiddling around. Noodle, what do you fly, man? Do you fly hog too? Because man, we should fly something. Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's a lot of, and you're so right, it is a lot of F-18s. Like, I love the F-18 and all, but, you know, there are other aircraft out there. Oh, we're aligned. Sorry, I got yakking. Who are we missing? Are we still in the start cycle? What have I done this time? It's okay though, because we were aligned. So, alright. That was a little bit of a cheat. You're just gonna let that start cycle finish. Yeah, I know. APU, you actually still can leave on. But I left the gen on, you are correct. Man, that sounds really cool. And yes, yeah. I think that was the problem. Now I just need to figure out what the hell's going on with my track IR. There, that's a little better. Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves, Corey. Jeez. Oh no, I already did all that. Alright, that was what's during on. Let's get to the runway. So you're a dedicated close air support group, eh? That sounds fun. Sorry, I gotta get my... I only got my tablet to view comments, so I just gotta get it moved closer, but I just want to get set up on the runway first, and I'll read what you got to say there. Hey man, absolutely. And being that you guys are like primary close air support, that sounds like something that I might actually do. So keep a lookout for me, man. Alright, so I just want to check on a few things. How's our MAV doing? Okay, that's done. Reset our TID. Keep my CDU, but I want to check the TGP. It is good. TGP is good. Alright. Let's move to attack. Heading off to make some dinner. Yeah, absolutely, man. I will check you out right after we're done here. Thank you very much, and you have a good night and have a good dinner. Okay, folks, we're on takeoff now. Again, we're a little heavy this time again, so 125 knots is around what I'm going to be looking at. Behave it this time. I did like that. 130 might be it. Ooh. Pull back somewhere. Positive ring. Up we go. Laps up. So we're on our way again. We're gonna take care of those tanks. Let's get on route this time again. This time we're gonna be ready. Let's learn properly. So I'm gonna set my trim for climb right now. Unpack laser and TGP all on. Good. Alright, now we're going to set Mavericks on the Dismas. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget that if you're new in here, don't forget to throw me a follow. It really helps me out on my road to affiliate and maybe trying to do something with this. Maybe get some a little bigger. Alright, so we're on route now on climb, so we're gonna once again set up our TGP, make sure the TGP is set to soy. Trying to head forward. I'm going to open up my tabs so that I can line up where I'm supposed to be. And we'll keep an eye out for those tanks. There they are there. Easy. Dumped our nose there. Okay. those of you out there watching, any of you guys play DCS? Let me know in the chat. So, slant range 32. So, quickly. Mavericks. So, we'll get the Mavericks on. Oh, whoops. Actually, my bad. So, there they are. Alright, so we're gonna keep it there. Actually, the way I'm gonna do it, throw 10,000 feet a little high. A little bit off my target here. Oh, I hate these tags, man. There. Okay. And I'm gonna try and speak up, sorry. I know it is loud. Okay. Still can't see anything just yet. Forget in there. There's our tanks. All right, so now you should see what I see. Yeah. Oh yeah, no, that's what I plan on doing. I just wanted to see if I could see it using the different modes. By the way, welcome there, Smola Gaming. Good to see you. See, that's why I don't like doing that. It's exactly why you just said that. A little out of range, yeah. Alright, here we go. And rifle. Oh shit. Watch this one blow. Kind of like watching it through the TGP anyway. Should be any second now. Oof. Rifle. I know he says it sucks, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Yep, okay. Before we have to do another emergency landing today. At a high enough angle. Pop some flares out there. Thank you. would explain what my trip is for. Try and get him with the bird again. Just keep, like, giving him a chance to... I'm not getting close enough, I know. Alright, so we're gonna spin back around, let's see what we do. Left MFCD. Okay, yeah, yeah. Well, they've run into a bit of a problem here, though. An issue. Well, I can't really do the rest of my mission if I can't mess around with my stores. Got any suggestion there, Smola? I actually did not know that. That's why I like getting you guys in the community on here, because it's very helpful for me. I see. There you go. So now I can move my stores. Thank you. That really helps. Never claim to be an expert. We're gonna try another gun run up here. So you think I should be going on a higher angle there, Small?
Pull up.
All right, I think we're going to move on to something else for now. But we're definitely learning things. We're getting somewhere. Okay, yeah, we're gonna try and do this attack on this compound here. hell, how well that goes. First, let's get an eye on it. Sorry folks, I'm just concentrating. Sorry, I'm not quiet on you. Have some AAA. Oh, that looks like an ink blood. So we're going to try and check out the AA gun, and then we're just going to stay above altitude here for the igloo down there, I guess. And we need to quickly set up our GBU-31s to strike the compound. But I've got spare Mavericks, so I am going to... I brought D's. I can't force correlate, because I wanted to hit that little dude on the ground there, but it doesn't look like that's going to happen. I pressed the wrong thing. Imagine that. Quite a bit of challenge doing this with one MFD, I'm not gonna lie. Rifle. That is probably not going to hit. Oh, it just might, actually. Okay, so now we can set things up. And while we're in the cloud cover, why not? Get some distance between us and the compound. Ah, damn.
Warning, autopilot.
right back around. Hopefully get both those artillery trucks.
Pull up, pull up.
All right, pickle.
Warning, autopilot. Warning, autopilot.
God damn it, I just want to see the bomb drop, damn it. Nice, we got all three. That was a good hit. Quite happy with that. This time I'm gonna give myself enough distance to set up my run properly.
Pull up! Pull up!
Let's not hit the bomb on the way down. Oh, here we go. Don't overcorrect like you usually do. See? Oh, it did it! Oh, excellent. Okay, perfect. Good hit. That deserves a good F3 view. Good bombing run today, I'm quite happy with that. Okay.
Warning, autopilot.
Alright, so finally there's a convoy. Fairly easy, however, there is reports of it being defended by a helicopter. An eye out for that. Check my Dismas, see much god ammo I got. Might be able to just do a run, zip around, and hopefully take care of the helicopter. We'll see how that works. that looks like a couple of trucks. Let's make them not there anymore. What do you think, guys? One AGM-65D Maverick. I think that is what, 500 pounds? I think that's enough to blow the crap out of that. I think so. Let me know in the comments. So I think I'm gonna try it. Jeez, Mavericks, where were you looking? Two got away. Alright, that's okay. Guns it is. Thank you. crash or give up on it. It's been waiting 2 hours and 8 minutes for me. Probably just got tired of me. I'm not waiting for that idiot anymore. Oh, is that 3 trucks down? Is that what I'm seeing?
Pull up.
That's all the trucks down. I'm still worried about this helicopter. I don't know if it's here or not. F10 map. He's even here. He is not. He is flying home. Let's get him. That's okay. Let him run. It's time to go home. We don't have the fuel to chase him down. We have a 93-mile trip home, so let's get on that. Check our stores. Let's see what we got. We got 1 Maverick left. Hang on. Wait a second. Let's trim up a little bit. I have some unfinished business. I want that one. Currently 55,000 pounds. We make our way to Starpoint 2.
Warning, autopilot.
43 miles away. Back up. Oh, sorry, I left you. I gotta learn to fix that, like, right away. £500 of fuel, so we're pretty good for that in that regard. Not much to look at right now. Remember, we are making just a quick detour on a 93-mile flight back home. Alright, we're good to go. Rifle. The details they've got on the weapons. You can actually like read them. What? Yeah, play it. Alright, here we go.
Warning, autopilot.
So that's our target down. Tanks are snipers, so we gotta be really careful. Going in at quite a slant range. Oh, sorry.
Pull up! Pull up!
Do it right. We're gonna get this done. We're gonna get it done. Do I have much ammo left? 210. Probably enough to one kill a tank. One? Why am I shaking so much? Oh, it's fine. Down to 60. Not doing it right. Oh well. All right. Unfortunately, it's time to return home. We have nothing left. Let's go. Ooh, it's kind of hot in my room right now. All right, 48 miles to go.
autopilot.
Yeah, I'm gonna save the aircraft. Get a look at where we're gonna end up here. I think we'll end up parking at any of these. If I recall correctly, the runway is 31.
Warning, autopilot.
Not much to look at now. That's the beauty of flight setting. Doesn't take much to relax me in this environment. So not a bad completion, I'd say personally. We, after some hiccups in the first run and ditching our first A-10, we came back out, took out a fair chunk of Apollo and tanks, finished a strike on our enemy targets. So 1 second, please.
operate with that on deck. Just gonna basically hit the tarmac and call it at the end of the stream. Say today that the winds have changed. Set up in a good position. Anyway, so after a long 2.5 hour stream here, we've seen some pretty interesting stuff. Got to learn today on how to run off 1MFD. That was kind of interesting. Not sure what hit me that caused that image, but you never know with DCS. Rather short approach, so we're going to get set up now. Turn about 3,000. Slowly descend as we go. I do. think that's a little far. Let's half that. Okay, let's get into position. We have the flaps. Keep it here a little better. We're on our base. A very short final.
Altitude.
Myself a good dinner, some homemade burgers on cheese buns, so I'm real excited. Alright, we're gonna come to a rolling stop here. Try and get off the runway. After I get off the runway, we'll end the stream here. Thank you so much for watching, and those of you who are watching, don't forget to leave a follow if you want to get a taste more of my content. Thank you very much for watching. Have yourself a good day.